Okay.
Hello, and welcome back to Music That Is Captivating. Uh-oh. Now we're into something. Lenny White. Chicaria al de Miola. That's quite an interesting outfit Chick has on. What, did he just get off the boat? What, is he in port for the weekend? Either that or is he... I think he's auditioning for On the Town, the revival. Chick Korea. More like Chip Korea. And inside joke, one of the characters' name was Chip in On the Town. How many of you don't know that? All right. Oh, hey, interesting facts we don't need to know. Yeah, everybody who's anyone in Fusion played on Bitches Brew. Take that to the bank. Except Stanley Clarke. Stanley never played with Miles. Lenny did. Oh! Now, for my money, I'll take Lenny White over Billy Cobb. How about that? Oh. Yeah. Shit, I'll take Lenny White over Tony Williams. I'll take Lenny White over most people. Lenny White for 100, Jack. Alright, that mustache, the purple... I think he's a background... I think he's an extra for the movie Cruising with Al Pacino. What? That's not bad. It was a good movie. If you like that kind of stuff. This is like progressive weirdo jazz. A young Al Di Meola. And gold top Les Paul. Stanley Clarke on alembic bass. Yes, alembic. Same bass that Phil Lesh used and Jack Cassidy. Oh, space shuffle. Yes, even in space we must swing. Stanley with the fingers of God fingers. Hand of God. Stanley Clarke, the greatest bass player, and then Jaco came along. Whoa! That's because he played the upright, he can do that. Oh, Lenny. Lenny Wizite stealing the shizzo. This is weird music. You know, the only thing not weird about this is Lenny White. He's actually totally killing. And Stanley. A lot of it, though, this is weirdo music. Jesus. That was pretty insane. Now, compare that to what Weather Report was doing at that time. I kind of feel like the Weather Report stuff is a little more, stands the test of time a little more. But, you know, they're amazing musicians. That's a little odd sounding. Compare that to Heavy Weather or Black Market by Weather Report. I don't think it compares, in my opinion. It doesn't stand the test of time. That being said, Lenny White stands the test of time. That man defined the sound of time. It's time to take some time. Be sublime with Lenny White. Yes. I'll tell you, there's an album from 1975 by Stanley Clarke. Now, what is that album called?
Journey to Love?
Yes, that's it. Lenny White's on it. Steve Gadd's on it. I like that more than this, actually. Actually, growing up, that was one of my favorite albums. And it's got Silly Putty on it. And Les Claypool did a version of Silly Putty. For better or worse. Oh, and then School Days. You know what? Stanley Clarke, in my opinion, I like Stanley Clarke's solo stuff more than Return to Forever. It was funkier. School Days was insane at the time. That shit was, like, groundbreaking. Not to mention the great album cover with the graffiti on the subway platform. But like I said, yeah, that was like 1 year before Jocko came out with his album. And then Jocko just devastated the whole world and took his right title as greatest bass player ever. All right. That's my opinion. Thank you very much.